So by now we've all seen everything having to do with the BSOD day from CrowdStrike and their famous update. And I was actually going to make a video about this on Saturday, but on Friday night I had an error of my own when I went to record the video and I finished and then realized that the video file was corrupted. And so I didn't feel like redoing it. Anyway, I decided to just wait a few more days, see what we could figure out more about it. And actually Microsoft released a tool, and I thought that's something that not a lot of people have talked about. So we can talk about this recovery tool that Microsoft released and like what it actually does. So this tool, when you go to download it, it's basically just a PowerShell script, and it's a lot of window dressing, basically just to delete the corrupted file. So when you download the PowerShell script, you'll run it, it'll ask you some questions, and it'll install the so-called Windows Assessment and Deployment Kit, if it's not already installed, and that will allow it to create some boot media. And there's two different options that it will create, like described in the blog post. The first one uses one method where you have to type in the BitLocker recovery key, and then it'll delete everything. The other option is it will allow you to log into the computer using its own credentials, but you have to know the admin login and stuff to do that. So there's two options. And you can see within the PowerShell script, it basically creates like this couple batch files on the fly, and we'll look at the actual batch files in a second. So once we have it create both ISO files, which are like bootable images, I extracted them and then compared them, and they're almost identical. The main difference between the first and two at the root level is that the second one has this extra script called repair.cmd. Again, we'll look at that in a second. And then also the boot.wim files are different. These are like more images and decide what's in the computer. But even within that, they're almost the same. And they both have this script that automatically runs called csremediationscript.bat. And these are just slightly different. So first we can look at the second one. This is the safe mode one. It's a bit simpler. And you can see that this basically just runs a single command, bcd edit command, which tells the computer to reboot in safe mode. That's literally all this whole thing does. And then once you do that, it tells you to manually run this other repair.cmd that we saw before. And all that does, again, is displays some text with some info and then just deletes that corrupted file. On the other hand, if you use the first ISO version, the one that talks about WinPE, they both kind of use WinPE. But anyway, this first one has a little bit more info. It's all done at once. So this tests if BitLocker is detected and asks for the key. And once you enter the key, it'll see if it's correct or not and ask you to try again or try a different drive if not. And then once it's able to, it again just deletes this file. The file in question, you'll see it referred to a lot as C00291.sys, but that's not actually the name of the corrupted file. That's like a pattern that like lets you delete it. The real one is not going to have that wildcard. It's going to look something like C00291, then a bunch of zeros and some kind of number. That's like the actual file name, but these patterns that people keep talking about, it's just easier to show that. I did try to run both ISOs in virtual machines, but since I don't actually have a Windows installation on those virtual machines, I just purely created it with these ISOs. It didn't work, but you could literally see in the bash script what it would do anyway. So not super complicated tools, probably will get the job done. The problem was not deleting the files, but like getting to them. Again, if you have BitLocker, you have to do all this nonsense to enter the recovery key because normally you wouldn't be able to boot. And how BitLocker usually works is it automatically decrypts on the fly with the normal login credentials. So if the computer won't even boot into Windows, then you can't decrypt it. You have to use the manual backup key. And that's why the second version has it with safe mode, because then you will be able to boot it and log in and then just delete it yourself. And then the first one just decrypts it with BitLocker manually and deletes it once it's decrypted. Now, as for why this one specific file was causing so many issues, I've seen a lot of analysis and there's nothing really definitive yet. A lot of people are talking about, obviously it's some kind of bug, but they're not really sure like at the assembly code, machine code level, what exactly is going wrong. One person posted a tweet that was like, got very popular. They were sounding very confident saying, oh, it's a null pointer. But then there were some other people that responded saying it might not actually be this. It looks like they did have code that was checking for null references. And then someone responded that. And at this point, I didn't even understand like half of it. But basically, no one's really sure. One theory that makes the most sense to me, and someone posted a reason for this, is it could have been uninitialized data in a variable. And the idea is that if this was the case, it might have actually worked on CrowdStrike's team when they were like doing some limited testing, and then when they pushed it out on most machines, it just happened to crash it, but it didn't on their testing machines. And that would explain some situations like where at Home Depot, maybe only 1 in 5 of the devices crashed, but at other places, like everything crashed. But at the moment, still no one's really sure, other than they really screwed up and they should have tested it more, because obviously this was a pretty widespread common problem. It's not like it was super rare. Anyway, not much more to say about it. If you guys are interested, I made another video talking about WinPE and like bootable stuff. I'll put that link right there if you want to check that out. So thanks so much for watching, and I'll see you in the next one.